The PM Garib Kalyan Package Insurance Scheme that covers health workers who are fighting coronavirus has been extended for 180 days. The Health Ministry made the announcement on September 15. The insurance is applicable to private hospital staff, community health workers and many others alike without any age restrictions. Rahul Gandhi accused the BJP government of failed promises during the coronavirus crisis during the monsoon parliament session. The Wayanad MP also slammed the centre for making plans of defeating COVID in 21 days, which had very little chance of happening. The schemes like the Aarogya Setu app and 20 lakh package were also mentioned. IIM Indore announced major developments in the exam pattern for the common admission test, which is to be held on November 29. The exam is said to be conducted in 3 sets and the duration has been reduced to 2 hours. The last day to register has been extended to September 23. With an aim to promote e-learning, Goa government has collaborated with Siemens and Conway Genus to install digital setup in Angamwadis across the state. Goa Health Minister mentioned the initiative is taken up under the Digital India Mission and will begin from Angamwadis in Sattari and Ponda Taluka. Shriram College of Commerce and an online learning platform Vedantu will organize National Economics Olympiad for grade 11 and 12 students. SRCC has invited applications with the last date set as October 30. The online Olympiad will be held in 2 rounds on November 1st and November 8th. The Karnataka government will be distributing over 60,000 smartphones at a cost of Rs. 65 crore to the Angamwadi workers across the state. The move will help teachers to upload the students' details such as height, weight, growth and immunization status to the common applicable service under the Poshan Abhiyan scheme. Japan formally elected Yoshihide Suga as the Prime Minister of Japan on September 16. The successor and right hand of the previous Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, Suga will announce his cabinet soon. The 71-year-old Suga was chosen by the country's lower house of parliament after the leadership proceedings on September 14. Israel, UAE and Bahrain signed the Abraham Accord at a ceremony hosted by Trump at the White House. Israeli PM Netanyahu, foreign ministers of the UAE and Bahrain agreed to establish embassies and exchange ambassadors. The accord also stressed for working together to improve tourism, trade, healthcare and security. The United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization reported a loss of nearly 100 million hectares of forest in 2 decades. It indicated that sub-Saharan African and South Asian forests suffered major losses. It also noted the agriculture and animal husbandry as major reasons for deforestation in less developed nations like Ivory Coast, Indonesia, Malaysia and Brazil. Apple hosted its larger-than-life event named Time Flies virtually on September 16. CEO Tim Cook revealed that the event would focus on 2 products, the Apple Watch and the iPad. The Apple Watch Series 6 was launched with new capabilities, namely blood oxygen meter, Memoji, etc., starting at $399. The new iPad Air 4 sports a 10.9-inch liquid retina display, a 14 bionic chip, USB-C port, etc., starting at $599.
Thank you for listening to Briefly News. Have a wonderful evening.